Hi, everyone. Hi, I'm here. Want to do one more video for the day. A buddy of mine said he had some camping stuff to get rid of. Cook kit, some other stuff, and he asked me if I'd be interested in it. And never one to turn down a freebie or look a gift horse in the mouth. I said, yeah, sure, not knowing what it is. When he said Cookset, I thought maybe he meant something like a Boy Scout Cookset or something. And this is what he brings to me. An all-weather alcohol Cookset designed for Australia's outdoors. Pretty cool. It says it has fry pan, a pot holder, windscreen, alcohol stove, two-quart casserole. So open it up. There's this aluminum kit with a belt. Looks like these things never even been opened. I mean, I've opened it to look at it, obviously. Frying pan, lid cover, pot wrench with holes in it, all the lower weight aluminum, little stove that looks like one of those, what do they call them, Tangias? I think that's how you pronounce it. And several pieces. Two aluminum pots. Doesn't say what the sizes are anymore, but they fit inside each other. And this is the windscreen pot stand. Goes like that. Pot stand, or the stove goes in there like that. And here you have a windscreen and a windscreen and the stove down in. Pot goes right in there like that. I guess the heat just comes up from the inside. There's not a very big space between the pot and the stove. But the heat must come up through the sides and out through the holes. A lot like that volcano stove that I did. But unlike that other burner that I got at Goodwill, I got a lot of heck for that, for not lighting it. I'm going to try this one, see what it does. Later on, I'll do a boil test and see how well this works. There's no instructions with this that I saw. So I'm just going to guesstimate here and just put a little alcohol in. Put in there that, like that. Now, unlike the Tangias, I have to be careful here. This lid has a gasket on, so that means no putting it on there hot. But there's no simmer rings. But I'm sure I can come up with something for that. Okay, that's lit. Let me turn out the light. Okay, it's warming up. There are holes on the top around in the circle, just like the Tangia. They're starting to light. I guess if this was made for Australia, maybe it doesn't like this kind of temperature. It's about 49 degrees here. That's starting to warm up now. Pretty cool. A little bulky, but pretty cool. Then this would go on here to act as a windscreen. Of course, now you can't see the flames, but that's warm. That's why I couldn't get it in. Then there's a smaller pot. in a larger pot. And the pot wrench that just goes on there like that takes it off. I guess you can see the flame a little better now. Pretty neat. I think I've seen these on eBay. Said that when he bought this it was $19. So not bad. This may have to go into my Bob or into the car, one of the cars. And that would go in there like that. I don't know if you can see the flames there. It's still lit. Oh, that's hot. Okay. I'll have to do a boil test on this. See how well it does. If anybody's used one of these, let me know. Let me know what you think of it. See if it's a worthwhile addition to the Bob's or, you know, survival packs or whatever. Again, it burns alcohol. Pretty nice little flame. I wonder if I can duplicate that. Anyway, thanks for watching. Let me know what you think. Always look forward to your inputs, your questions, remarks, and watch for Max the Dog. Bye now.
Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling until then.
Good boy, Max.